Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. In this video we'll see how to resolve fqdn and print IP address, how to handle exception while resolving hostname, and how to print local machine hostname. In the previous two videos we have seen how to scan a particular port on remote machine and print the status. You can see here I scanned 0.10 port 80 and printed the status of that port. Similar way, in the second video we have seen how to scan range of ports and printed the status here. In this video we'll see how to resolve on fqdn and print the status of that server. So for that, first I'll duplicate this script. I'll give the name fqdn. I'll rename this to 3. Now here first we'll go to the socket document. Here you can see gethostname. This returns a string that contains hostname of a hostname where Python is running. So first we'll try this. Let me copy this. I'll put it in the script. Start executing the script from, and I'll give this. Now let's try running this. You can see now it has printed the host name of my machine. You can see here the host name is Ubuntu OS. Now we'll see another function. We'll go to this document. You can see here getfqdn. So we'll try that. I'll print fqdn of IP. Let me just try running this script. You can see my 0.10 server's fqdn is esxi.test.lab, and 0.1 is a wireless router, and that fqdn is rilink.dlink.com. Now we'll try to give a valid domain name. Just try giving cisco.com. We can see the fqdn of that particular server. Now if you want to print the server IP, print, we'll see here get host by name. So that will translate name to IPv4 format. So we'll try this. Let me copy this of IP. Here I'll create a separator for each IP. So you can see here, okay, I will give some description here. fqdn is, and similar way here, IP is. Now let's try executing it. Now you can see it is printing. You can see here, even in cisco.com, it is printing the IP address of the server. Now, but in this case, if you give an invalid name, qwp, let's try running it. You can see we are getting an error here, GAI error. So we'll search for that error. We'll try to handle that error. Yeah, you can see there are multiple errors. We can handle each error. So in this case, I'll be handling this error. So we'll be using try except method. So what we'll do here, after print statement, I'll introduce try, and now we need to move this to this under try, and here except, and that error what we received. Okay, let's put that error from the document. And if this error happens, print could not resolve host, then we'll give the IP. So IP means it will take this name as IP, and after that it should pass, otherwise it will stop there, and any other exception print exception occurred. We'll give a pass here. Now let's try executing it. Here we have received error, no address associated with hostname. That means exception occurred before even coming into this statement. That means error occurred here as well. So what we'll do, give a try here as well. And here except print, we'll give exception occurred. While getting IP, we'll give a pass here as well. Now let's try executing it. Yeah, you can see here, now this is completed. You can see we got the IP. While getting the IP also, we got an exception and could not resolve the host name. So that also we have handled here. Now let's try giving a valid IP. We'll give cisco.com. Yeah, here you can see the fqdn and IP address of cisco.com. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.